Morphology of stem. In last lecture we studied morphology of root and now we'll study morphology of stem. Okay, now what are the characteristics of the stem? The aerial part of the plant is collectively described as shoot system. Main axis of the shoot system is called stem. Stem can be defined as the ascending part of the plant axis which develops from the plumule. Okay. Root developed from radical and adventitious root developed from other parts of the plant except radical, and this stem will develop from plumule. It is usually negatively hydrotrophic because it is growing in opposite direction of the water movement, negatively geotrophic and positively phototrophic. Okay. It bears a terminal bud and axillary bud in the axis of the leaves for growth. It is differentiated into nodes and internodes, and at the nodes it produces dissimilar organs such as leaves and flowers, and similar organs such as branches exogenously originate from the outer tissue. The young stem is green and is capable of performing photosynthesis. Okay. So it is the aerial part of the plant. Main axis of this is called stem. Stem can be defined as the ascending part of the plant axis which develops from the plumule, negatively hydrotrophic, negatively geotrophic but positively phototrophic. It will bear terminal bud and axillary buds. It is differentiated into nodes and internodes, and at the nodes it produces dissimilar organs such as leaves and flowers, and similar organs such as branches exogenously originate from the outer tissue. The young stem is green and is capable of performing photosynthesis. Okay. Now, buds. Buds in the stem can be vegetative as well as floral. So the buds which develop into flowers are called the floral buds, and the buds which develop into branches are called the vegetative buds. Apical buds located at the apex of the stem. Okay. Now you can see in the diagram, axillary buds which are located in the axil of the leaves, accessory buds which are located on the sides or above the axillary buds, and adventitious buds located at the areas other than the nodes. See in the diagram, you can easily make out, this is the apical bud. Okay, this is located at the apex of the stem. Apex means tip of the stem. Okay, axillary bud is present in the axil of the leaf. What does that mean? If this is the stem and this is the leaf, so this portion is nothing but the axil. Okay, so the buds which are located here are called the axillary buds. Okay, other are the accessory buds. Now these accessory buds are located on the sides or above the axillary buds, so they'll be located above the sides of the axillary bud, and adventitious buds located at the areas other than the nodes. So these adventitious buds will be located at the areas other than the node. Okay, they'll not be located at the nodes. See, when we see a stem, this is a node. Okay, this is a node, and the distance between two nodes, this is the other node. So the distance between the node is called internode. Okay. So these are the buds which are present in the stem. Now when we talk about the functions of stem, the primary function of the stem are to produce and support lateral appendages such as branches, leaves, flowers and fruits, conduction of water and minerals to different parts of the shoots, and transport food to all parts. Stem may however get modified to perform additional or functions such as storage of food and water, proliferation and propagation, procuring support for climbing, perination, that is tied over unfavorable condition, and synthesis of food, that is photosynthesis. Okay. So modifications of stem can be underground, subaerial and aerial. In underground modification we will study rhizome, tuber, comb, bulb. In subaerial modification, we will learn runner, stolon, offset and sucker. And in aerial, we'll learn tendril, thorn, phyllode, callode and bulbil. Okay. So first, we'll study the underground modification. In many herbaceous plants, stem develops below the soil and is called underground stem. Such stems remain dormant during unfavorable condition and give off aerial shoots under favorable conditions. These underground stems often store food and become fleshy. Underground stem perform three functions. Okay, one is the storage of food, perination, and vegetative propagation. Now these can be differentiated from roots by stem-like internal structure, exogenous branching, presence of nodes and internodes, occurrence of foliage leaves or scale leaves at the nodes with axillary buds, and absence of root cap. Okay, so you can differentiate between the root and the stem by seeing these particular features. Okay. Now underground modification, first we'll study rhizome. Now rhizome is prostrate dorsiventral thickened brownish stem which grows horizontally under the surface of the soil. Okay, as you can see in the first diagram, it shows distinct nodes and internodes. It possesses a terminal bud and axillary bud in the axle of each scale leaf present at the node. Rhizomes remains dormant under the soil, and at the onset of favorable condition, the terminal bud grows into the aerial shoot which dies at the end of the favorable season. Okay, so this is the rhizome. You can see here this. Okay, this is the prostrate dorsiventral thickened brownish stem which grows horizontally under the surface of the soil. Okay, now comes the tuber. Tuber, you can see that potato is a tuber. Remember, sweet potato is a root modification, but normal potato is a stem modification. So tubers are actually the swollen ends of tips of special swollen underground branches due to the storage of food, that is carbohydrate like starch. The tubers show nodes and internodes, bare scale leaves with axillary buds, commonly called as eyes. Okay. You must have seen these eyes, and the part of potato containing these eyes is able to do the vegetative propagation also. Okay, so these eyes are nothing but internodes which bear scale leaves with axillary buds. Okay, under favorable condition, these eyes sprout and produce aerial shoots. Thus, tubers help in vegetative propagation. Tubers do not produce adventitious roots. Thus, they differ from rhizomes. Okay. They do not produce adventitious roots. But in rhizome, there is production of the adventitious roots. Example is potato, that is Solanum tuberosum. Now underground modification, that is bulb. It is a condensed disc like underground stem which itself does not store food material. Okay, it itself does not store food material, but the upper surface of the disc like stem is slightly conical and bears centrally placed apical bud and many concentrically arranged overlapping scale leaves. Now these scale leaves will store the food. Okay. Inner scale leaves or leaf bases store food and are thick and fleshy, while outer few scaly leaves remain thin and dry and are protective in functions. Lower surface of the disc like stem produce adventitious roots. Okay, you can see in both onion and garlic that when you see the bulb structure, okay, you will find here many fibrous like roots. These are nothing but the adventitious roots. Okay, an outer layer of the leaves is very thin and dry and they are used for the protection, but inner is fleshy and stored food. Actually it is a stem modification, but here the stem does not store food. Here the leaves, that is the scale leaves, store the food. Now underground modification, that is the corm. Corm is a short, stout, fleshy, upright and thickened underground stem. It bears many buds in the axil of scale leaves which develop into daughter corms. At the bases or even from sides the stem of stem, adventitious roots develop. Corm is a condensed form of rhizome growing vertically, that is Arabi colocasia. Okay, zameen khan, that is Amorphophallus. Now this is a short, stout, fleshy, upright and thickened underground stem. Okay. It will bear many buds in the axil or scale leaves which will develop into the daughter corms. At the bases or even from sides of stem, adventitious roots will develop. Okay. Now comes the aerial modification. In aerial modification, we'll learn about the stem tendril. Okay. Here you can see in the diagram, this is what? This is the stem tendril. Okay, it is a modification of stem in which axillary bud modifies to form a thin, wiry and highly sensitive structure called the tendril. Tendrils will help the plant to attach itself to support and climb. They are found in plants with weak stem. The tendrils are leafless coil structures with sensitive adhesive glands for fixation. For example of axillary tendril is Passiflora, that is passion flower. In Vitis, apical bud is modified into the tendril and further growth is resumed by the axillary bud. And in Cucurbita, extra axillary bud is modified into tendril, while in Antigonum, floral bud is tendril. Okay. So, the function of the tendril is to provide support, okay, for adhesion purpose. Now, aerial modification is a thorn. Thorn is a hard, pointed, usually straight structure produced by modification of the axillary bud. Leaves, branches and flowers are developed on thorns at the nose, indicating that it is a modified stem. It will provide protection against the browsing animals. The animals will browse less on the plants which contain thorns. Example are citrus, bougainvillea, datura, etc. In Carissa, apical bud is modified into the thorn. Now, other example of the aerial modification is phylloclade. Now, phylloclade or cladophyll is a stem which gets transformed into leaf-like structure. You have to remember that phylloclade is the or cladophyll is a stem which gets transformed into leaf-like structure. The phylloclade is green, flattened structure and with distinct nodes and internodes. Now, it is thick, fleshy and succulent in Opuntia and Nagphony. Cylindrical in Casuarina and Euphorbia triculi and ribbon-like in Muhanambekia. In xerophytes, leaves get modified into spines or get reduced in size to check the loss of water due to transpiration, and the stem takes up the function of leaf, that is photosynthesis. And when the stem is modified to take up the function of leaf, that is photosynthesis, we call it as phylloclade. Other aerial modification is the cadode. Okay, these are green branches of limited growth, usually one internode long, which have taken up the function of photosynthesis. True leaves are reduced to scales or spines like asparagus. Other is bulbil. When axillary bud becomes fleshy and rounded due to the storage of food, it is called bulbil. It gets detached from the plant, falls on ground and develops into a new plant, that is Dioscorea. Okay, now these are the subaerial modification, that is runner. These are special narrow green horizontal or prostrate branches which develop at the base of the erect shoots called the crowns. Many runners arise from each erect shoot. They spread in different directions and bear new crowns above and tufts of adventitious roots below at certain intervals. Each runner has one or more nodes. The nodes bear scale leaves and axillary buds. Okay, that is the common example is the lawn grass. Now you can see here, there is a creeping branch. This is the ground surface. Okay, this is the ground surface, and there will be creeping branch on this ground surface. Then again, it will get into it and form a grass plant. Okay. Then again it will be creeping and this will form like this. So this is what it look like, it is running on the ground. So it is called what? It is called runner. You can see here. Okay. The other modification is the stolon. Stolon is a slender lateral branch that arises from the base of the main axis. In runner, there was no arising of the lateral branch, but here you will see that the branch arises and forms a particular structure. Okay, initially stolon grows upwards like an ordinary branch and then bends down and touches the soil, where its terminal bud give rise to a new shoot and adventitious roots. Okay, it will be like that. This is the main ground, so this is the main plant. Now the last branch will grow upright and then suddenly it will go into the ground and form the new one. Okay, then again it will happen. So this is stolon. Now offset is a runner of aquatic plants. Okay, it is found in aquatic plants. It is shorter and thicker than runner. Short and thicker than runner. It helps in vegetative propagation in aquatic plants. Example is water hyacinth. Okay, that is Acornia crassipes, and Jalkumbhi, that is Pisthia. Now in sucker, sucker is a runner like a non-green branch which develops from the axil of the scale leaf in the underground part of the stem. It grows horizontally below the soil for some distance and comes above the soil obliquely and produces green leaves to form aerial shoots. The sucker can therefore be called underground runner. Okay, it will be like this. It will be like this. This is the ground. The plant is growing like this. So one of its branches will go underground. Okay, it will go underground. It will grow there and it will come and form a new plant. So this is what? This is the runner. Okay, underground runner, or we call it as sucker. Example is chrysanthemum and mint. Okay, so today we studied about the morphology of stem.